So let's talk about 13. Let's see how far we can go. So 13 says the mountain range and its image on a lake. So what kind of transformation would that be? Okay. What's funny is I actually have that picture. Check this out.
Reflection.
See the mountain on the lake? I might want to actually take this over and take a look. So that would be a reflection. The mountain reflected into a lake would just be a reflection. That's the kind of transformation that would be done. So 13. Translation, sorry, not the transformation would be translation, right? Okay. Oh, no, not translation. Why am I tripping? I'm reflection. We said reflection. I'm tripping. Sometimes, morning, I need my coffee. Reflection, right? To reflect it into the... It's like, you know, you have this mountain range, and then you have this lake, go with blue, right? And then you have this same mountain reflected in the lake. It might help just to give an idea of what's going on. What's 15? 15. Wings of a butterfly. So, if you think about a butterfly, right? I remember, did you guys ever do this? I was talking about this, I think, to Lamont last week, right? When we were young, you know, in preschool, we used to do finger paint, right? And you would like create these wings of a butterfly, right? And then here's this, right, piece, and then you have this. And you put these like circles, do all this stuff, you know, right? Little dot, right? And then what would happen is while the paint was wet, you would fold it, right? You'd fold it right here. Okay? And then what would happen is you'd get that exact same picture, right? Over here. Let's pretend it's exact same. Okay? Kind of looks like Florida, but whatever. Okay? And then Florida before the storm and after. No, I'm just kidding. So, okay? You have this stuff where it's okay, and then your little okay. That's it. Like, what kind of transformation is that? When you fold the paper. Reflection. Yeah. Reflection. 15. Okay? Let's talk about 17 now. 17. So 17 says, okay, given some points, they want you to do a reflection across the x axis, or in 17, you want to do it on the y axis. Right? So in 17, they're like, hey, we're going to give you something. We want you to reflect it. Okay? And so they're giving you F is 3, 5. So 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 3, 5, that's F. Okay? Then they're giving you G is negative 1, 4. So negative 1 and, oops, sorry, negative 1 and 4. And that's G. Okay? G. And then H is 5, 0. So 5 and 0 is H. So I have this shape. Right? I have this shape. Okay? Now I gotta reflect it across the y-axis. The y-axis. That means I'm gonna be going that way, right? Here's the y-axis. Right? That means I'm gonna be going that way with it, right? Reflecting. Like if I fold it, it's gonna reflect. Everything's gonna move over there, and then everything over here is gonna move over there. So if this is at a negative 1, then G prime, right, is going to be at a positive 1. Does that make sense? This one's not going to change because I can't, it's on the y-axis, right? So it stays there. But this guy, F, he's going to move from 3 to negative 3. Right? So H prime is in its same spot. Boom, boom, boom. And that's your reflection. Okay? So, we're learning some rules here. Right? Reflecting, right? Something we should know is a y-axis reflection. We're starting to learn the x's become opposite. Okay? If you have xy, then what happened? Then the x became negative, right? Now this, the x was negative, but what's negative in a negative? A positive. Right? So that's all that's happening there. The x's become opposite. What do you think's going to happen on an x-axis reflection? What do you think will happen on an x-axis reflection? Come on, people. I know it's early. I've already made like 3 mistakes. But if I start with xy, I'm going to end up with x negative y. And what that's going to do is reflect it across. So if I wanted to, I could reflect this across the x-axis. And this would become negative 4. Right? That would be your h double prime. We're calling it double prime just because it's different than the prime. We're going to derive it from... You know what? Let's derive it from the red. Let's go, this goes here, that's prime, and then double prime we're going to derive from the red. So we're going to move this G. This G is at 3, 1 and 3, right? So it's still going to be at 1, but it's going to come down to negative 3. And that's your G double prime. So you did what? You did black is what you have. You moved it to red. And then you move red to become purple. So what am I going to do with F? Does anyone have an answer for F? Where's F going to go if I reflect it across the x-axis?
Negative 5.
Yeah. So it was at 5, and it just comes down to negative 5. It's still at negative 3. Notice how that doesn't change. The x doesn't change. Only the y changes. And that's your F double prime. Double prime because it happened second. Okay? It happened second. Okay? So the first came the red, prime, and the second came the purple, double prime. Now this isn't part of your answer to 17, but what's funny is this is where we're going in chapter 5, chapter 6, wherever it is, chapter 7, I forget where we're doing translations, but it gets intense. What they do is they give you this from this, and you have to tell me what happened. And you're like, oh, what happened? I don't know what happened. Oh, okay. So a couple things actually could have happened. One, this reflection, and then later on you're going to learn that actually it could have been a 180-degree rotation. But we'll talk about that. It's confusing. It gets very confusing later on, okay? Because there's a couple things that could have happened there. Could have rotated. Do you see how it could have rotated 180 degrees? Right? But we'll talk about that in chapter 6. Alright, next. 19, and then we're done, right?
No,
21. 21, darn it. Okay, so let's look at 19 and 21. They're both on the same problem. So 19 and then 21. These are going to be on the same problem. And what happened was, they have number 1 starts here. And I'll probably do it. It's 1 to 3 and 2 and 3. So let's just go 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, and 3. Okay? And then it's 1, 1, 2, 3. Is that what I said? 1, 1, 2, 3, and 3, 1. I think that's number 1, right? And then number 2 was this one, right? And then number 3, that was 2, okay? And number 3 is this one. And that's number 3. And then number 4 is this one. That's 4, okay? All right. Then they ask you a couple things. In number 19, they go, and so they tell you a transformation maps A, B, C, and then D, okay? So there's a mapping. It starts with A, goes to B, then to C, then to D, okay? And what they showed here is 1, 2, 3, and 4. It's kind of weird, but it should be, another word for one would be A, right? A, B, C, and D, okay? So what's happening is saying, hey, name the image of A. What one's A? If it mapped from A, we just did that, right? Name the image of A as number 1. Does that make sense? If it mapped from A, B, C to D, and this mapped from 1, 2, 3 to 4, then it makes sense that A must be 1. Are we all in agreement there? Does that make sense? Okay, now let's look at 21. Name the image of C. Which one's C?
3.
Da, 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 da. Now, let me ask you some harder questions, because that's your answer. That's it. I mean, 19 is 1, and 21 is 3, but I kind of want to ask you some harder questions, a little bit harder. How did we get from 1 to 2? How did we get from 1 to 2?
Reflection.
How did we get from 2 to 3? Reflection, right?
On the
But from 1 to 3, we could have reflected twice or rotated. You see what I'm saying? Okay. And then how do we get from 3 to 4? Reflection. Right? Or, now, rotation wouldn't work here. It doesn't work here. Okay? And it doesn't work here. But it does work there. It's weird. It won't work on the 90 degree. It does work on the 180 because everything gets flipped around. Remember? 180 degrees. You know, I'm like this. Boom. Turn it around. Simple. Okay? All right. That's it.